Now to send out my blood risotto with impaled snails. I've taken a real risk with this dish because some people are really squeamish about blood, but I'm confident that it tastes great.
Oh my gosh.
I like my supper brought to me like this every night.
No, totally.
Oh, come on. Wow.
It's definitely bloody.
It's bloody.
I see red.
Wow.
Look at that.
What's that smell?
Gotta put those in, right?
This is like,
what is it?
I'm gonna eat it.
Is it a vegetable or a meat thing?
It's Frankenstein's balls, isn't it?
It's a snail.
Snails.
Fantastic.
It's snails.
Absolutely delicious.
If that is a snail, it's the first time I've eaten one.
Would you like one of my snails?
I'll see how I feel after this.
Are you sure?
Yeah, but I might come back.
Did you eat the baby beetroot?
I'm good, thanks.
I think what happened if I'd have served the leeches. God.
As for this,
just throwing on it.
What is this, guys?
What's in it?
Whatever it is, it's good.
I'll just put your minds at rest. You're not actually eating.
I have no problem eating blood.
Really? Well, there's a little bit of blood in there, so that's good.
Thank you.
But it's actually a blood pudding.
I was really enjoying this until the blood they started talking about blood, and all I can see is a plate of blood. That's all I'm visualising at the moment.
And it's terrible because it tastes amazing until I knew it was blood.
This is right on the edge of what I'm trying to do with this feast, and it's whether I can kind of keep it on the enjoyable side and not push him over into horrific.
I'm gonna have my third snail.
Yee-haw!
This tastes completely different with your eyes closed. Close your eyes. And there's blood in the beetroot.
I know.
But it's delicious.
This is what blood tastes like. Sign me up. Sign me up. I'll have it in a milkshake. I'll have it in a croissant.
I had this push some of my guests to the edge, but I got them all eating blood. And I think the Count himself would have been proud of that.